Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss the last topic of our same chapter. Chapter 1, Representation of Geographical Features of the Earth. And what was our last topic? Components of maps. Before that, from this chapter, we have already learned the meaning of globe, map, their uses, their drawbacks, or you can say limitation, and different types of map. This much we have already discussed in our first video. This is our second video, and here we will discuss the last part of this chapter, that is components of maps. First of all, what is the meaning of this word? I already told you most probably in the first video. Component means language. We know maps are different types. Already you have learned political, physical, thematic, large scale, small scale, many types. So if we want to know those maps, know means if we want to describe those maps, if we want to interpret those maps, if we want to understand those maps, we have to use some components or languages which help us to do this part. And the components are title, number 2 direction, number 3 grid system, number 4 scale, number 5 color scheme, number 6 conventional symbols. Then there are 6 components. Clear? So one by one I am going to say about these 6 components. If you take any type of map, any, I think many of you have maps, many of you have atlas, already you have seen map. So any type of map if you take, you will get these 6 components. Actually these 6 components help us to understand a map. Like title. Suppose if you take one map, any map, one heading or name will be here. Here I have given question mark, I didn't write. This place actually used for title means here one name will be there. What type of map this is? This political map of India, physical map of Africa, whatever. So that is called title or heading, because title helps us to understand, to know what type of map is this. Clear? Now the next component is direction. Very useful thing. You know map means it's a flat paper, because map drawn on a flat paper. So if it is a paper, suppose it is a paper, it is a map, then how we will know the direction of each area or location of the map? Generally we know that sun rises from one side of our sky, that is east, sets in another side, that is west. But in map or on the map, can we see sun rising or sunset position? No. So here directions help us to understand which one is our east, west, north or south. Clear? So these directions are mainly two types. Here I have written direction, and we have two types of direction. One cardinal direction, another intermediate direction. These two types of directions help us to locate or to identify any place on map. Can you see one arrow here I have drawn, and I have written here N, means upper part of the map always indicates north. Again I repeat, upper part of any map always indicates north. So any map you can use, its upper part means it is fixed north. And it is fixed, keep in your mind. So north always come top of your paper, top of your map. If it is north, downward is south. Your right hand side indicates east and left hand side indicates west. Here I have drawn same thing, north, south, east, west. Most important 4 direction to indicate any locations on a map. and these four directions are called cardinal directions. So what are cardinal directions? North, south, east, west. These four directions on map are known as cardinal direction. Now, if this type of question comes, student, you maintain this sequence, this arrangement, north, south, east, west. This is the correct arrangement. Suppose you are writing this answer and you are writing these four directions haphazardly. Suppose you are writing south, west, north, east. It's a wrong arrangement. Wrong answer. Understood? You are writing east, north, south, west. Four are there, but your arrangement is wrong. You have to maintain this one, which one I have written. North, south, east, west. Means north always come first, then south, then east, and then last west. Cleared? After cardinal direction, four more important directions we have. In between northeast, in between southeast, in between northwest, and in between southwest. We are getting northeast, southeast, northwest, southwest. These four are called intermediate directions. And here I have written their arrangement. Here also you cannot change the arrangement. Always you have to write northeast first, then southeast, then northwest, then southwest. You have to maintain this sequence. And these four directions are called intermediate directions. Why they are called intermediate? Very clear. Because north is located in between north and east. That's why intermediate. Like this way we are getting four intermediate directions. And these four directions also help us to locate any place on this flat paper. So direction also very important component to understand a map. Now, third one is grid system, which one I already told you in our first video. Grid means a framework. This framework mainly developed with the help of latitude and longitude. And we are getting this kind of frame on a map or globe, which helps us to locate any place on a map, to identify any place on a map. Very simple. If you know, suppose I am giving one dot here, it is one place, place A, and if you know its latitudinal and longitudinal value, so easily you can say that place A is located within this grid. Yes, grid helps us definitely, but before that you have to know the latitudinal and longitudinal value. If you know these two values, then you can easily identify any place on map. Clear? Now our next three components, that is scale, color scheme and conventional symbols. I will start from number 5, color scheme. I have mentioned here page number 18. There one small table given, student, you just follow. There some colors and their meaning have written. I have given two examples only from that same table. Means if you see any type of map, student, you can see different colors on the map, because we know through a map we can represent earth's features, and those features have different color, so we use different color to represent on them on a map. Like if we want to show some vegetation, so we have to use which color? Green color. If we want to show the mountain, plateaus, plains, means relief or land, we have to use brown color. If we want to use settlement, we will use red color. Like different colors are there to represent different features of our earth. So one small table given on this page, page 18. You will learn that one and you will do that table. You have to draw the table in your copy. That is your homework also. I have mentioned color scheme. So that means color is one of the component to represent different features of the earth on a map. Our next component, very important one, conventional symbols. Yes, a big table given in our book, conventional symbols, page number 16 to 17. So this table homework I have mentioned, you have to learn, memorized all the symbols with their meaning, and you have to draw that table in your copy. That is your homework. Now, what is the meaning of this word conventional symbol? Yes, these are some symbols. These symbols are internationally accepted, means throughout whole world we use same symbol. For which purpose? To represent different features of earth on a map. Suppose we want to represent a river. River size and our map size. River is the bigger, larger, you can say, than our map. So not possible for us to represent as it is on that flat paper. So to represent a river, we use particular symbol. We want to draw some rail lines on a map. Is it possible to draw as it is? No. So we use some particular symbol to represent rail line. In case of houses, vegetation, different features. It can be man-made, it can be natural. We can represent them on a small paper with the help of some particular symbols. And that symbols are called conventional symbols. And they are internationally accepted, keep in your mind. Because whole world use the same type of symbols to represent same features. Means, as an Indian, if we use one type of symbol to represent a river, the people of America, same symbol use. People of Australia, same symbol they also use. So these symbols are called conventional symbols. Its meaning given page number 15. Just now which one I said, same thing given on page number 15 I marked. You just follow that one. And the last component, that is number 4, scale, here I have written. You know what is a scale. A scale actually a very small instrument. It helps us to take measure. Measure of what? The distance between two points on a map. So three different methods we can follow to represent these scales on a map. And the three methods are, or three types of scales are, which we can use to represent any map: statement scale, linear scale, and RF scale. So these three types of scale are very common for any type of map. Statement means directly one information will be written there, that is 1 centimeter is equal to 5 kilometer. Means 1 centimeter on your map is equal to 5 centimeter on your ground, on the ground. Okay, that is statement, and it will be written on the map. Linear, in case of linear, it will be drawn. First of all, one primary division will be there. See, I have drawn here 1 centimeter shows 5 kilometer, 2 centimeters shows 10, 3 centimeter showing 15, and this side I have done another division, that is called secondary divisions. Here 0.2 represent 1 kilometer, 0.4 represent 2 kilometer, like that way 1 centimeter is equal to 5 kilometer. So this kind of scale will be drawn on your map, that one is called linear scale. And last type is RF scale, representative fraction. This full form is representative fraction. Fraction, because it's two sign I have given here. It shows distance on the map. RF scale means it shows the distance on the map by distance on the ground. Done. So here 1 centimeter on map means 5 kilometer on ground. But the plus point of this scale is you can change its unit. I have given one example, 1:50,000, means 1 is the map distance and 50,000 is ground distance. What will be the unit of these two figures? You, according to your need, you can change these two units. Done. So RF scale is very useful for especially topographical map. So these are the three types of skill. So these are all six components of our maps. I think it is clear now. So all of you read these components very clearly and mark your doubts. Done. Okay. Now student, the last part of our chapter, sketch and plan. Actually our chapter is representation of geographical features of the earth, and it can be done very nicely and very clearly through map and globe. But except these two more diagrams we have through which we can represent our earth, but not in a very clear way like a map, but still we can do. And these two diagrams are sketch, another one is plan. Sketch, it is a kind of rough drawing. So I have written these two important words. Sketch is a rough drawing. It can be drawn very quickly. It comes from one memory and very quickly you can draw without any help, any kinds of help means I want to say about skill. Mainly skill. To draw a map, the main component was skill. All components were very important. The main one is skill. In case of sketch, we no need to use of skill. Without skill, we can draw a sketch. Suppose you want to explain your friend the diagram, the roads from your house to your school. So with the help of some rough drawing, you can explain it, and that drawing is called sketch. And to do that drawing, you no need any use of skill. So that is your sketch, that through the sketch you can draw what way you are coming from your house to your school every day. That is a rough drawing, sketch. But plan is a kind of large scale map. I told you, large scale map means through this map we can represent a very small area. Yes. So plan means it represents a very specific or small thing, like a large scale map. That's why I have written large scale map. And it gives detailed information. Yes. Plan gives detailed information. Then you can ask me, it is a kind of map. Is it kind of like topographical map? Because topo map gives us very detailed information about a small area. No. Topo map gives us more detail. Plan gives us some basic elements. Plan gives us ideas of some basic elements. Plan generally we make when we want to make some building, some park. So before making these things, to build up these things, we need plan. And plan is very important here. Skill is one of the factor. Without skill we cannot draw plan. So that is the main difference between sketch and plan. Sketch is a rough drawing. Plan is not a rough drawing. Plan is a large scale type of diagram which gives us a detailed information, and it shows some basic elements of that particular place. And the second difference, sketch, we do not use skill to draw a sketch, but using of skill is a very important part for a plan. Done. So this is the last part of our chapter. So now this total chapter you read, you do all the homeworks which one I had given already, and you mark your doubts. Now few more homeworks I had given, except making those two tables, conventional and color scheme. This homework is about your diagrams. Two types of directions we have. I explained cardinal and intermediate. Page number also I mentioned, on page 15 given. These two types of diagrams you have to draw in your copy. One cardinal, another intermediate. And only one question I had given, that is difference. Difference between plan and sketch. But the question is, how many points you will write? You will write 2 points. So you will write 2 differences between plan and sketch. Done? Understood everything? So now you do all your homework and very clearly, nicely read the whole chapter. Thank you.